For today's video, we're going to open up some pirate llamas and check out some of the heroes and weapons you can get from them. As you can tell, we have a total of 5,000 tickets, so we're going to open up 10 of them. And for those who don't know, the current best way to farm tickets is by completing your dungeon quest. Anyways, let's go ahead and start opening up some pirate llamas. The main reason I wanted to do this video, though, is because I wanted to share some information I came across in regards to Save the World. So a couple of days ago, I came across this tweet that says the job listing link for a full-time contract writer is no longer valid after a few weeks. Assuming this may mean Epic finally hired someone to write more quest content for Save the World. And with this first one, we got a Sir Hootie, which I don't think we've ever reviewed before. Let us know if y'all would like us to get some gameplay with this. But anyways, as for the job listing, for those who don't know, a couple of weeks ago, Epic Games posted a writer position, and one of their main duties was to write story content for Save the World. We did do a video on that job listing. I'll leave a link to that in the description if you'd like some more information about it. But yeah, basically they had a job listing where they were asking for writers who could not only help out with Save the World content, but also help out with BR. And they also had some other responsibilities. Now I did do a little digging myself just to see if the job listings were still available. And when I Googled it, I still saw a couple of job listings available for writer contracts that included writing content for Save the World. But when I clicked on the link that was in the tweet, that page no longer exists. So I'm not sure if they just haven't had time to take these job listings down yet, or if they're possibly still looking for some more writers. But I did see a couple of writer contracts available when I Googled it. And some of these that I found were posted like within the last 2 or 3 days. So I'm not 100% sure if they actually found their writer yet. I guess technically they could have found their writer and just haven't taken these job listings down yet. But considering how recent they are, that makes me think they could still be searching. And just wanted to point that out for those who saw the tweet. A lot of people were saying in the last video that they hope that they're going to get the Twine Peaks storyline. I'm not 100% sure if it's going to include a Twine Peaks storyline, but we should definitely at least get new quest lines. And I guess there is a chance it could also include Twine Peaks story. But if I had to choose what they were referring to, I would assume that they're probably talking about writing content for quest lines. Oh, it looks like with this one, we got a Spyglass. And I sort of wasn't paying attention to the last few we opened. But after we open all these llamas, we'll take a look at everything that we got. And there was another tweet that came out just a couple of hours ago where they talk about possibly adding Fortnite Save the World benefits to crew bundles. And in that screenshot, they included new Save the World heroes. Now, I don't know if they mean new or just new for that person getting the crew bundle, but that was another little piece of information that I came across just recently, and I'll leave a link to that tweet in the description as well. But yeah, they could possibly be adding some Save the World benefits to crew bundles. And that's all of the information that I came across recently in regards to Save the World. So let me know what y'all think about the writer position possibly being filled, and let me know what y'all think about Save the World benefits being included in crew bundles. And we already have both of these. Let's go ahead and get the Corsair, I guess. And technically, we haven't reviewed the Corsair. I have uploaded gameplay of it before, but we were reviewing a hero, and that's what I was mainly focused on. So if y'all would like us to do the Corsair, let me know. They're the perks that came with it. Anyways, as of right now, I believe I'm level 12 in the new Venture Zone. And I kind of want to get to a higher level before I do like a review slash tip video for it. But let me know if y'all would like some tips for the new Venture Zone. Maybe some good loadouts you can use. Let me know and I'll start working on that. Get the Jack's Revenge with that one. Or if y'all prefer, we could also go over dungeons, because there's still a couple of dungeons we haven't done a walkthrough for. We've done a walkthrough for Inferno. I'll leave a link to that in the description. But if y'all would like us to do a detailed walkthrough for Grotto or Crypt or Labyrinth, well, I don't know about Labyrinth, but for one of the other two, let me know in the comments and we can work on that. And we already have both of these as well. Let's go ahead and get the Duelist, but you can't get Old Betsy as well. But yeah, I was thinking we may try to speed run some dungeons this week on Twitch. Speaking of which, I do plan on streaming on Twitch later today. But yeah, let's go ahead and open up our last llama and see what we get from it. And then we'll check out everything that we got. All right, so with this one, we got an Old Betsy. We also got an Epic Defender. And that's everything we got from it. All right, so when it comes to schematics, we got the Corsair, the Duelist, Jack's Revenge, Old Betsy, Sir Hootie, Spyglass. And those were all the epic and legendary weapons we got. Let's go ahead and put this in the collection book. Let's see, when it comes to heroes, we got Buccaneer Jonesy, Privateer Hype. And those are the only pirate heroes that we got from our first 10 llamas. And we also got quite a few defenders as well. So that's everything we were able to get from our first 10 pirate llamas. Let us know in the comments what you were able to get from yours. I'm pretty sure you're not going to be able to get the bundle bus or the bowler. They're usually available in the event store. Same thing with the walloper. That'll most likely end up in the event store. But you should be able to get most of these other weapons. I'm not 100% sure about the powder keg. Let me know if y'all are able to get the powder keg from the llama. But as for the rest of these weapons, you should be able to get them from the pirate llamas. And when it comes to pirate heroes, I believe you can get most of them except for Blakebeard. You're going to have to get him from the Yar quest line. And I don't think Hybrid's going to be available either. I'm not 100% sure on that. So let us know which pirate heroes you got from your llamas as well. But yeah, that's everything I was able to get. And that sums up everything we're going to go over for today. Again, let us know if y'all would like us to go over dungeons next or go over some tips for the new venture zone. Anyways, that'll do it for this one. Hope y'all found the video useful, and thanks for watching.